If you were looking for an exotic experience at the Kansas State University Open House on April 5th, all you had to do was stop at the Exotic Animal Medicine Club booth at the College of Veterinary Medicine. The popular display included snake skins, skulls, and other specimens, plus radiographs, live reptiles, and a darting station simulating how wild animals are vaccinated.
The response has been great. People are always fascinated by wildlife, and it's kind of something you see in your backyard but you never interact with. People want to know more, so they love being here, and we love having them and being able to teach them and stuff, so the reaction's been great.
Open house is just one activity the club uses to educate the public and its members about this area of veterinary medicine.
So the Exotic Animal Medicine Club tries to introduce students to the three types of exotic animal medicine that you can achieve as a veterinarian. The first is actually being a wildlife veterinarian, so that would be a type of clinic that you bring a sick raptor or sick owl, eagle, something that you find in the wild. You could also be an exotic pet clinician, and that would be something like if someone has a sick rat or a sick bird, sick chinchilla. And then the third portion is the one that I actually would really like to go into, and that's a zoo veterinarian. So that would be a veterinarian that takes care of every single animal you see when you go to the zoo.
The club has one meeting per semester that features a guest expert speaker and a yearly behind-the-scenes visit to a nearby zoo. Activities include two wet labs each semester that allow students to get hands-on experience with different exotic animals. The club also maintains a small educational collection of reptiles and invertebrates called the HERP, or the Herpetarium.
Currently we have two snakes, one corn snake named Maisie, and one hawk-nosed snake named Hissy. We also have a bearded dragon named Chomper, box turtle named Sparkles, a blue-tongued skink named Edna, and a crested gecko named Scotch. And we have two tarantulas, and they're named Rosie and Harry. Well, when you think about animals, like, people don't really think about reptiles as pets because snakes are scary and spiders are scary, but these guys are really docile and they can come to you and then curl up in your pocket, and that's one of the appealing things about working at the Herp.
With these animals and its many activities, the club provides students a chance to consider a less familiar aspect of veterinary medicine.
Usually, when you go to a College of Veterinary Medicine in Kansas, you expect to come out a livestock veterinarian, but that's not always the case because we have such a strong exotics program here. So I think that it's a really good experience for those students who just aren't sure what they want to do yet, and they're trying to expose themselves to new and different experiences. I think Exotic Animal Club is a really good fit for them and a good place for them to come explore.
To learn more about the Exotic Animal Medicine Club, visit the club's webpage.